Welcome. I am Collins Trott, Child Development faculty on the Wallace Community College Dothan campus. In this episode, we are going to be learning about It Takes a Village, teachers, families, and communities. As communities reel from the impact of troubled families crumbling from change and stress, everyone realizes that healthy families are essential. Furthermore, it is in the best interest of everyone in the community to support families so they are effective in their child-rearing functions. When families are left on their own to do what they can without the support of the larger community, the community bears the brunt of the family's failures. The entire village that it takes to raise a child, about which we have heard so much in recent years, realizes that the vision that supports children, families, and the institutions that serve families is a vision that impacts us all. In this episode, we examine the ways the community at large affects schools and the families they serve, and the ways that teachers and families may function as advocates for child and family issues within the community. Together, teachers and families have the power to inspire community support that will mutually benefit them, their schools, and the children for whom they care. As children learn to live within their communities, they contribute to the communities that support them and their families. So join me, Miss Trott, as we learn all about It Takes a Village, teachers, families, and communities. Children live in many worlds, home and family, schools, the neighborhoods, and the community beyond shape their lives. Just as every family is unique, so too is each community. The idea of Bronfenbrenner's ecological systems theory portrays the child developing within the context of five nesting interrelated systems of relationships that form their environment. These ideas suggesting the importance of examining the interconnections among the ideas and structures that surround the child and family. Bronfenbrenner's principles clearly show the connections between values and decisions of the larger community and the effect on the children and their families, and the importance of the families and schools that exist within the larger communities. Actions taken by communities impinge on the functionings of the families and the schools, and in turn, actions of the families and teachers can influence the community. The increased awareness of childcare, need for educational improvements, and other family needs have brought corporation leaders into discussion and collaboration with other community organizations in efforts to improve services offered to many families. Many communities have included corporate leaders in their child advocacy organizations and school systems. With awareness comes policy, and they become involved in ways to ease the stretch of family care for the workers. Employers are educating themselves about community, schools, and childcare needs and becoming collaborative partners in the private sector. The public sector is also increasing awareness of children's and family issues. Political initiatives and media campaigns have directed national attention to the needs of working families and the childcare community. More recent legislation passed to aid in these efforts are the Temporary Assistance for Needy Families, Family Medical Leave Act, and No Child Left Behind. In these times of enormous social problems and limited funding sources, many agencies within the community have found it productive to form linkages to support each other's services. Collaborations come in all shapes and sizes. Public and private funding collaborations and interdisciplinary alliances result from common community concerns. Teachers may play an important role in helping link families with community agencies that can provide needed services. Teachers work with families to seek help from the community, neither judging nor pitying families that may need resources. Every teacher should know what community resources exist in order to refer families. Because of their positions, teachers and families have the capacity and obligation to influence community segments that are making decisions that affect their lives. As those who best know and care about the needs of developing children, parents and teachers are uniquely suited to be advocates working to convince the community of what actions must be taken on their behalf. As people who see firsthand the everyday issues facing children, their families, and the childcare and educational community at large, teachers must be advocates within the community. Where does a teacher and advocate start? First, become visible. Perhaps the most important starting place is to realize that our image and definition of educational professional must change, and teachers can start small by joining local neighborhoods or school groups that work to improve the quality of life in the community. Second, be informed. Community issues and policies are developing rapidly and continually. Teachers need to keep informed about problems, issues, and proposals at local levels and beyond, and to know how these matters and proposals affect education, childcare, and family support. Third, tell the story. Many people who are not directly involved with education or young families have no firsthand knowledge of problems and concerns. Teachers have the stories to illustrate the information and passion in demonstrating the contrast between what could be and what is. Making methods obvious and outcomes clear helps the community understand what the vision is, how far from the vision the community is, and the action plan needed to reach the vision. Fourth, adapt and replicate. Every community is unique in its organization, specific populations, and problems. But some programs and ideas have worked well in communities around the country. Rather than try to reinvent the wheel, advocates should become familiar with these successful endeavors. Not every program will work in all contexts and climates of support. It is important to take advantage of the information that already exists about what programs are most effective at various stages of community organization. Fifth, join professional organizations. Teachers become empowered as they unite with others to learn, support one another, define professional goals and standards, and wield political power. The political power of a large professional organization can yield results. Sixth, connect with community power structures. Before advocates can go into the community looking for support for education and children's issues, they need to identify three things: who is out there, who among them are known personally, and who are the significant others. Seventh, contact representatives. As concerned citizens and professionals employed in specific capacities, and as members of professional organizations, teachers and parents need to contact their legislative representatives and state their positions, along with the specific reasons for their beliefs. Lastly, vote. Advocates must follow up on their interests by learning what responsive actions businesses, government officials, and others who can shape policy have taken. With the power of purchase choices or voting decisions, teachers and parents can express their approval or disapproval of particular actions. As private citizens, families and teachers can support leaders who favor family and education issues. Schools exist within particular communities, and each community has much to offer as a resource to teachers, planning curricula for children in the classrooms. Teachers need to assess what the community can provide. Resources may be categorized as natural resources, people resources, and material resources. Within the reach of most schools, teachers may find businesses, shopping areas, transportation system, and depots, construction sites, police and fire stations, parks and recreation areas, churches, zoos, museums, and residential streets. Each one of these offers countless learning experiences. In addition to using the natural resources within any community, teachers and parents can take opportunities to help children develop an understanding of community responsibilities as they practice stewardship and protection of the environments and resources around them. Every neighborhood has its own socioeconomic, racial, and cultural composition. Teachers who familiarize themselves with the customs and lifestyles of the people in the community surrounding their schools may find richness and diversity to share with the children. Parents themselves may be the link to assisting teachers in learning the community's people resources as they disclose aspects of their home lives. Many community service agencies have representatives prepared to explain the agency to the children by sending volunteers to the school, such as a firefighting coming and bringing the fire truck. People resources of all types can enrich a school. Teachers and parents should also remember that children can learn how they themselves can be resources for their own communities. Students can even participate in service learning projects no matter their age. No child is too young to learn valuable lessons of making contributions to others and feeling responsible as a member of our community. Teachers who make community connections can find their classroom the recipient of many objects children can use. Teachers should make lists of all community businesses and then brainstorm all possible material resources for the school in the community. Most business people like to feel like they can make a contribution to their neighborhood schools. Now let's review what we've learned. Corporations may become involved with family and education issues. There have been legislation that supports families and schools. Collaboration within the community supports families. Teacher and parents can take advocacy roles. And communities may be able to provide resources for teachers, children, and families. That wraps us up for this episode. You can learn more about this topic by reviewing the resources posted in your course. As always, if you have any questions, please contact me or your instructor. Thanks for joining me, Ms. Trott, as we learned all about It Takes a Village, teachers, families, and communities. See you next time.